In this video, I'll walk you through how to write logs to Seq. Seq is a self-hosted search, analysis, and alerting server built for structured logs and traces. Let's get started. This is the Seq website. I'll provide the URL in the video description. You will find some information on the homepage. You can download Seq from here. Windows and Linux Docker options are available. Seq is already running in Docker on my machine. This is a demo web API project. I have also created another web API project with CRUD functionalities, create, read, update and delete, using entity framework core, which I'll show you after explaining the implementation. Let me open the NuGet package manager. Here you can see the libraries I have already installed for Serilog implementation. You only need serilog.enrichers.correlationid if you want to display the correlation ID in the logs. I'll show you how to do this soon. Let's move to the Browse tab and install serilog.syncs.seq. Now in our program class, let's use the builder.host.useserilog method to set up the configuration. We'll set the default minimum log level to information. I'm also overriding the minimum log level for Microsoft.ASP.NET Core and setting it to warning. Next, let's add the correlation ID enricher. This is optional and should be added only if you need correlation ID. If you want to learn more about correlation ID and Serilog enrichers, you can watch the video linked in the description. Next, let's specify where to write the logs. We'll write them to the debug and console windows using a custom output template. Let's also write the logs to Seq. We can provide the Seq server URL as a parameter with 5341 as the default port number. Since we are using correlation ID, we need to add HTTP context accessor to the dependency service. Finally, let's enable Serilog's request logging functionality. We can assign these configurations from app settings if needed. Let me show you how. We just need to specify that the values should be read from the configuration. This approach allows us to make changes by simply modifying the app settings. First, in the app settings, we need to create a configuration key named Serilog. Then, we can assign the minimum log levels. Next, we can include the namespace for the correlation ID enricher and mention including the correlation ID in the enricher section. After that, we'll provide the write to section. Since we are writing the logs to the console and debug windows, I have included both along with a custom output template. We'll add one more item inside the write to section for writing the logs to Seq. Inside the arguments, we can specify the Seq server URL. Let me add some logs to our API method. We'll write the logs when the method is initiated and just before returning the result. I'm also including the result in the log. To display the result in proper JSON format, we can use an @ symbol here. Let's try triggering our API method now. We can see the logs in the console window. Let's check them in Seq now. You can open the Seq web panel using the server URL. I configured a custom port while installing Docker container. Here, we can find all the logs on the events page. It is possible to expand each log to view the details. Let's try executing the API method multiple times and you can see the logs accumulating. Seq provides an easy filter option. Let's filter by correlation ID. Here, we can see all the logs matching the same correlation ID. The dashboard offers counts and charts that help us monitor the frequency of different types of logs. We can even create alerts if needed. If you need to delete the logs, you can either do it manually or set a retention policy. We can also enable authentication if needed. This API application showcasing Entity Framework Core CRUD functionalities serves as a reference for understanding and implementing structured logging in CRUD APIs. You can access the project source code through the Patreon post link provided in the video description. Let's add two products and observe how the logs are displayed in Seq. All the logs have been successfully added in Seq. By clicking on the db command log, you can view all the details included: action name, command text, correlation ID, etc. Let me show you an example of a warning message. I'm attempting to fetch a product with a specific ID, but there is no product matching the ID. Here you can see a yellow mark denoting it as a warning. You can also filter logs by their log levels by clicking here. When we delete a product, the log will include product details as well. I am trying to execute the delete method again with the same ID, and you can see the logs with warning messages. Next, I'll show you an example of an error log. Let me try to update a product with the ID we have already deleted. Here you can see the method has returned an internal server error response. Seq will mark the logs with a red color. We can also filter by the log level to see only error logs. By expanding the log, we'll be able to see the exception details. If you need to track all the logs of this particular request, we can filter using the correlation ID. Now, we can see the request details, DB command log, and other logs for that particular request. These options make Seq a powerful tool to track every event in our application. Don't forget to check out our Patreon page. You can access the CRUD API source code using the Patreon post URL in the video description. If you found this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.